Hello, world. Lisa Friedrichsen, your computer science professor and friend, with another short screencast about Access. And thank you for all the kind words and encouragement about my Access A to Z playlist. That has spawned several questions about common Access database problems. And so I decided to make an epilogue to that on how to fix common Access problems. And these are really common relational database problems when data is not properly designed and entered in the first place. And the first example is when someone has typed in the entire name, the first name and the last name, in a single field. And the problem with that is, of course, you can't sort by last name, at least not easily. And you also can't parse that data in letters or reports that address only part of the name. So here's what we want the data to look like. We want the parts of the name to be broken into their own fields. And I've got a first name, middle name, and last name field here. Some of these records actually did have a middle name. And I had a colleague once that said every name is actually six fields. First name, middle name, last name, title, Mr., Mrs., Dr., suffix, junior, senior, the third, and also nickname. Roland may want to be called Raleigh. So I'm going to just show you how to break out the first, middle, and last name out of a single string. And then from there, you can keep going if your data needs require further specifications. The first thing we want to do is create a new query. And we're going to add the customers table because that's where that field is, the contact name, that contains both the first, middle, and last name. Then we're going to create some calculated fields. To determine the first name, one thing we're going to need to know is where is the space in that string, because the first name is one character less than the position of the space. Now, for this first record, Maria Anders, the space is in the sixth position. For the next one, Anna, the space is in the fourth position. Let's build a calculation that determines the location of that space. Calculated field name, colon, and then I'm going to use the instr, instring function, and look in the contact name field for the second argument is a space. So that would go in as quotation mark, space, quotation mark. Now, these columns are not that wide, so you can right-click and zoom and get the zoom dialog box to see the whole expression easier, or you can just widen the column as well. So let's save that query. We're going to call it separate string and look at it in datasheet view. And so now we've calculated the location of the space. Now that we know the location of the space, we can then go ahead and pull out the left side of the space and the right side of the space. Let's do that. In design view, I'm going to write first name, and then I'm going to right click and go into the build dialog box, because the expression builder dialog box allows me to pick through the functions, the built-in functions that will help me calculate what characters are to the left of that space. And if I go into the text category and scroll through these different functions, I'm going to find one called left. It returns the strings containing a specified number of characters from the left side of the string. If I double-click that left function, then the expression builder attempts to help me with some prompts. Now, I don't need this expr prompt. I'm going to delete that. But the left function is telling me that it needs a string and it needs a length. Well, the string is going to be the contact name field. And the length is going to be the space minus one. I'm going to save that and look at it in datasheet view. And it looks like I pulled out the first name, the first five characters for Maria, the first three characters for Anna, and so forth into that first name field. Let's go ahead and try it on the right-hand side. The last name would be the rightmost characters, again, from the contact name field. And I want everything to the right of that space. And so the number of characters to the right of the space are the total number of characters, which could be defined as the length of the contact name, minus the number of characters up to the space. So let's see how that works. And I've got the last names now. And as I scroll through these records, I see that I do have some records where I've got a first, middle, and last name. So I'm going to have to go back to design view and rename this field. It's not really the last name anymore. It's just the last part, and continue finding spaces. So the second space would be a similar expression in string, and I'm going to look in the last part field now for a space. And let's see if we have any second spaces. And most of these last part fields do not have a second space, but if I sort that field by clicking it and then click the descending sort button, I see that several records do have a second space. And so I only have two records here where the second space is greater than zero. Figure out the middle name by using that same pattern that I used to figure out the first name, only work against the last part field. Back to design view, the middle name is going to be, let's zoom on this. I'm going to use a left function again, and I'm going to work on the last part field, and I want everything from second space position minus one. I want all of the characters from the beginning of the last part through the second space position minus one. Let's click OK there, look at design view, and the middle name is giving me this error message, and that's because that second argument is that second space minus one. Well, it can't look for a negative number of values, so I'm going to have to surround this function. I'm going to zoom again. I'm going to have to surround this function with an if statement. In access, the if function is IIF, and I'm going to have to check if the second space is equal to zero, then there is no middle name. And I'm going to indicate that with simply quote, quote. If the second space, though, is not equal to zero, the second part of this function will calculate and we will figure out the leftmost characters in that last part before the second space. Okay, and datasheet view. And now, do we have any middle names? Most of the people do not have a middle name, but Jose Pedro does. And if I keep scrolling down, Miguel also does. Now that we've got the first name, the middle name, we need the final last name. Back to design view. For that one, I'm going to want to pull off the rightmost part. So last name is going to be the rightmost part of that last part field. That's going to be the length of the last part minus the second space. Save, look at datasheet view, and there's the last name. And if we go down to Jose Pedro, we also see that his last name has calculated correctly. If you sort ascending and descending on these calculated fields where you've calculated pieces of information, lots of times your outlier records will move to the top. And then if you want to sort on the last name, now you've got that calculated and you can easily create a report on this query that has the last name separated out. And to underscore the power of calculated fields, know that they will always and automatically update when the original raw data changes. So for example, on this first contact name, I'm going to change that to my own name, and you're going to see all of these calculated fields update as well. Lisa Ann Friedrichsen. As soon as I move off that record, watch the space, first name, last part, second space, middle name, and last name update. And now all of those fields are updated. Any other query or report that's based on this separate string query will automatically update as well. In the next screencast, I'll show you how to use this query and connect it to existing tables so that in any future query or report, you can use these calculated fields. Thank you.